Today is December 17th. This is the Mycroft Dev Sync. Let's just jump into it here. Kez, how are things going?
Great. Had just so much sleep last night. Just feel super rested.
Oh, you too, huh?
Yeah. I spent a bit of time merging Ken's Mark II skill changes into the latest version of that skill, and then I added some placeholder event handlers for Wi-Fi setup, so we can make sure to, you know, provide the instructions that we had, like on the KV image, when using the Wi-Fi connect, you know, set it up on your mobile device, that sort of thing. Still need to look at what the best way of tying that together is, you know, whether Wi-Fi connect emits messages on the bus, or whether we respond to the state of the Plasma network manager, or anyway, we'll figure that out. Antcore has been tracking along. They've got all the audio output working. There's still, Ken's been working with them a lot over the last, thanks, Josh. Ken's been working with them a lot over the last, overnight, or, you know, all day today, looking at particularly the audio record and the ITC and that sort of stuff. So they still haven't got that squared away, but the other stuff seems to be coming in well. We should be on track. Presuming we can get over this hump, we should be on track for a nice demo tomorrow. So,
excellent. All right, excellent. Thank you. I apologize. I was using my other mute button and I did not realize that it was the wrong microphone that was connected to the call. So that's why you guys were hearing all the kids screaming in the background. So apologies for that. All right, great. Well, that's good. I'm looking forward to the demo. And do they have the R4 board up? That's what they're using now? Awesome. That's great. Great. Okay, Ken, let's go to you. I heard your name mentioned.
Sorry, let me just get back to this guy real quick.
Okay, then let's go to Chris Vare.
So right now I am running a very long job to rename all the wakeword files on the precise server with the naming convention that we came up with a while back. The naming convention was causing me problems, or the fact that the old files were not named correctly was causing me problems because I changed code to, you know, have the naming convention. So I am doing that as part of my effort to get data for Ken. And I made some more changes to my conversion process as well. As I ran it, I found some more issues with it, just related to all the changes we've made so far. I'm still working on that. It's taking me longer than I'd like, but hopefully today we'll have some data out there for Ken to play with.
Okay. Are you waiting for a process to complete, or are you still actively like debugging things?
Right now I'm waiting for a process to complete, but preparing for the production push as I watch this job run. So, okay. Yeah.
Okay, great. Thanks. Ken, are you back with us?
I am. So let's see. So I reviewed the Blue System skill pull request this morning and approved that. I finished the code I need to get the counts using the Selenium URLs instead of pulling directly from the database like I was doing. I will be integrating. I started actually integrating that with the existing code that I have already running, but that's quite complex. It's been a while. I have some, not Jira tickets, but some Confluence pages I got to look up and remember what I was doing there. It's been a while. I'll continue with both of those things tomorrow. So I'm working with Panacor right now on their build. They're getting really close. He's got everything running on his image except for not able to get a record working, which ultimately appears to be an issue with the I2C bus and the XMOS reset strategy or whatever. He verified that he was able to pull one of our QT builds. I pointed him to 26. I don't know if he took that or 37. I told him all bets are off on 37 because I haven't tested it yet. But whatever he did, he took one of our QT builds, he applied the monkey patch, and he verified that everything on his end works. So it's not hardware. It's something to do in their image. And that's where we're at right now in that process. So they're really close. I'm confident, pretty confident he'll figure it out. So, you know, hopefully we'll have something image-wise from them soon. Yeah, so like I said, I'll continue working with Panacor tomorrow, and I'll continue on the wakeword tagging integration stuff.
Awesome. Okay, great. Derek, you have anything for us?
Yeah. Let's see. So this morning I got the LaserCut files uploaded and did some quotes and stuff, and I sent that over to all of those involved. Looks like we could get some stuff if we want to move quickly in early January without expediting. You know, with expediting, you can get stuff much quicker. And then I've been working on the Wi-Fi stuff in terms of the GUI side of that. The two things, Ricardo had asked me to review the active portal side of the GUI, and I've got a couple just tweaks on the copy that I'm gonna request just to make it a little bit more instructional, and then at the end to add a link to account, well, not necessarily a link, but instruction to go to account.mycroft.ai just to get people to jump on that. And a little styling change. And then the rest has been on the actual screens that display on the Mark II itself. The screens have changed, will need to change from what we were doing in the vertical orientation. So I was getting the assets together so we can finish that up and updating a few things because it's changed slightly with the Panacor design versus what we did internally before. So I'll be getting those together maybe by the end of the day here. And yeah, that's me. And the other thing is I was kind of reviewing the SJ222 specs that you put together, Michael, on the fan, and I got a comparable one to test that I could get very quickly. So
yeah, both Kevin and I actually already have fans that we've tested. So in terms of the, you know, testing our circuitry and stuff, what I'm looking for now is a supplier that will, you know, that can give us a fan at a reasonable price that actually, you know, gives us the thing that we're asking for. Because I just don't want to, you know, fall victim to a miscommunication about what the specs are. And since there's not really any hard standards about these things.
Yeah, I actually don't even care if this one.
Okay.
I had a little glitch there. I think internet dropped off. But yeah, to be clear, I don't even care if this thing plugs in and turns on. I'm just going to make sure I don't have any clearance issues in the design. And then you know, I can use the wires and stuff to like finalize the wire length and everything. But yeah, I don't necessarily care if it works. But it's the right dimensions.
Gotcha. Okay, great. Thanks. Josh walked away just in time for me to call on him.
I got this auto update thing done for the Raspberry Pis. So, and then they gave me a repo to push that through into, and then I have a flat out.
What repo did you use?
I haven't pushed it to any repo, but you guys told me the repo, and I saw an email from you. Yeah.
No, I didn't see it. What repo did they tell you to use?
I suggested Mycroft Devices or DevOps. Any preference from anyone on the team?
No, the only reason I ask is I may have some similar scripts I'll need to put somewhere, and I wasn't sure where they would go. Okay, so Mycroft devices, where it is, great.
Yeah, yeah. A top level directory that's like, you know, hardware setup, I don't know, something.
Okay, and then I'm sending Derek's final test for the laser cut to the thing right now, and then I'm holding a ridiculous amount of clear PETG filament and starting that thing rolling. And then I wrote a children's book.
So,
and an investor update.
I just wanted to interject on the location for that script. Josh, is that a script that is supposed to flash the Raspberry Pi's firmware? Is that what we're talking about?
It's the one that checks the Pi firmware, checks for the latest firmware, and then grabs it and updates the Pi if necessary. That's a two-step process. You have to boot the device once to pull that down, check it, and then push it. And then you have to reboot it and make sure the firmware actually updates. So I just threw a toggle into a little temporary file that says either you're on first boot or second boot, and then it'll just toggle back and forth.
And so, let me point out that if you don't do that, the second step, or if you don't do it correctly, it's not that you'll brick your Pi, but it won't allow you to update the firmware anymore. And you'll be stuck with using an SD card, because I have one in that state right now that I have to figure out how to hard reset.
Yeah. So anyway, it's a two-step process, and then the LEDs, when it's confirmed everything's good, they flash green, and away you go.
Okay. So this is just a utility for us before we package up the Pis to stick into the dev kits, right?
Yes, because otherwise the USB stick that we ship with it won't.
Right. We'll be useless.
It won't be a boot.
So I would like to offer that maybe we should stick this in a utility directory off the Mark II hardware repo.
Yeah, so good point. and I was going to say, for example, I'm going to have a similar need for maybe power on self tests or hardware testing scripts, which are specific to the Mark II. What you're talking about, Michael, doesn't really exist. What you're talking about is a branch that's off of Mycroft Core.
My proposal for how we organize things, though.
Did you mean, sorry, when you first said it, I thought you meant the actual Mark II hardware repo, like the one that specs out the SJ201s and all
that. That would be a good place for it as well.
Maybe, yeah.
Anyway, somebody just point me at where they want it, and I will shove all that stuff in there.
I'll send you a link to that one.
Okay. And then I was productive, so yay.
Cool. I've been less productive. I had another day of doctor appointments with the kids. So chugging along on getting the fan spec'd out. We should have a bunch of samples arriving next week. So we can put in fans in the kit that don't cost $15. We're getting the PCBA is underway. Kevin and I have approved the final SJ201 layout. It's on revision 11 now. So now the we'll call them Rev 5 boards. Kevin should get some in next week, and that'll be our test just to make sure we didn't break anything on the new layout changes. And then there at the same time, we're getting quotes back from the fabs for the high volume runs. Oh, right. I'm doing this. I guess that's it for everybody. Anybody have any other? I'm in charge. Wait, who thought that was a good idea? What's next? Anybody have any things that we need to talk about? Or
I think what's exciting is we might have a working image by tomorrow from Panacore that everybody can test early next week when they get their hardware. I think that's a good thing to kind of end the meeting on.
Yeah, I agree. Good point. Yeah, so we'll record that, and if it goes well, we'll show it to everybody. And if it doesn't go well, we'll show it to everybody anyway.
So, we can always edit it out if it doesn't go.
We'll fix it in post.
And we can go back and say, that was fake news. We didn't say that.
Yeah, no more fixing it in post. We're showing you the real stuff.
Something I forgot to mention.
Okay.
Something I forgot to mention was one of the reasons I'm renaming these files is I was finding, as I copied some files over initially, I had like 15,000 copied over. I was playing with the tagger, and a lot of the samples I was getting back were like zero length audio files. So there wasn't anything in them. And because of that, the thing that shows the audio is just a blank, and I didn't know what to do with it. So part of this script that I'm running now is renaming these files is also looking for the correct headers in the WAV file and looking for the number of frames of greater than zero in the audio file. And basically I'm writing out an error file of any files that I find that meet that criteria that we can deal with later. But it was going to be a bad user experience if, you know, half the if, you know, half the samples you try to tag were empty.
Oh, that's a good catch.
Yeah.
So it sounds like we may not have as many samples as we thought as well. That'll be another consequence.
You know, it's such a small sample size. I mean, you know, it was just the first, I don't know, several that I tried to tag. So it may just be that I unluckily got the worst ones in the beginning. But yeah, I'll let everyone know how many okay. wind up in my error bucket when this job's been running.
Great. Yeah, that's good to know. Awesome. Anything else people want to share? Okay, great. Well, we'll see y'all again tomorrow then. Thanks very much.